I'm Natalie Herbick, and I have a huge smile on my face today because I'm on island time enjoying one of the coolest spots around, Put-in Bay. You see the golf carts flying behind me, the boats are here. This is the place to be, and if you've been here before, well, we're gonna show you some of your favorite spots. If you haven't, we're gonna give you a tour of the island. One of the best stops, the boardwalk. But before we go there, I'm gonna show you how easy it is to get here. Let's check it out. Less than 30 minutes and you're in a summertime paradise, I must say. Nicole, the Jet Express is the way to go.
It certainly is the way to go.
It's easy too because you have these coming to and from the island and here. Is it every half an hour?
It's about every 45 minutes.
45.
We leave out of downtown Port Clinton into Put-in Bay. So yeah, it's you miss that one. We have a bar right at our dock and people can sit there and have a drink right on the water and wait for the next boat to come. So.
And who's gonna complain about that? If
nobody.
They're getting ready especially to come here for a little getaway,
right.
We'll start at the bar
Get the party started over there.
That's what, I mean, there's no secret to that. That's what Put-in Bay's all about,
it
right?
It is, certainly is.
It's time to have fun. And you do make it so simple, and I know this is something that people can easily get across, and I love how you have the seating on the boat. How many people can you fit?
We can fit about 375 people, and we have indoor and outdoor seating, so if people want to feel the wind in their hair, we have that for them, or if they want to sit inside and listen to a narrated tour, we also have that on the inside. It's comfortable seating, handicap accessible, so we got something for everybody on the Jet Express.
And what all do they give on the narrated tour?
We talk about the different islands that they see as they're coming across, or some facts about Lake Erie. So just kind of what the sights and the sounds that they're seeing on the trip over. So really the experience does start at our dock and, you know, your trip to Put-in Bay starts there.
I like the sound of that. Now, seasonally, things change as far as the times of the jets.
Yeah, it depends on the day and the time of the season. So they can always check our website at jet-express.com and you can click right on the day you're traveling and see what time the departure times are.
Clearly summertime peak time. So what is the earliest and the latest that you can get on?
Yep, our first boat is always out at 8:45 a.m. And then depending on the day, the return times back change, but we're always the latest service off the islands. And on the weekends, 12:15 a.m. or later is when we come back. So yeah, you can really enjoy everything that Put-in Bay has to offer.
I love this. Now you have added something new, and that is where you service in the local area here.
Yeah, that's right. We always serviced Put-in Bay, and then we added Kelly's Island a while ago. And then this year we have service that stops at Cedar Point. So when people are departing out of Sandusky, they go Sandusky, Cedar Point, Kelly's Island, then Put-in Bay. And the great thing about that is people that are at the island, they can jump right on the boat and head over to Cedar Point. Or if they're at Cedar Point, stay in a few days, they can hop over and have dinner or whatnot at the island.
Oh, what a great,
yeah, it's great
idea and a great way to connect so many great places that are in Northeast Ohio.
Right, yep, so they can just come and stay in one spot and then we connect all the pieces together for them.
And I mean, it's honestly perfect because when you get here, you are right downtown. You're in the heart of Put-in Bay.
Yeah, we drop you off right in all the activities so they can just jump off the boat and it's less than a 5-minute walk to all the bars and restaurants and shopping. So you really don't need any additional transportation once you get here. But if you do want to rent a golf cart or a bike, we have that right on our dock as well.
Well, and I have a feeling I'm going to be renting one today because you know when you start walking around here, you start feeling like maybe it'll be nice to get around on a golf cart
yeah,
too.
Yeah, there's a lot of great stuff out like Heinemann's Winery and Perry's Cave, so it's always fun to take the carts out there and experience all that too.
Well, I think this one's setting up and setting sail back for the mainland.
Yeah.
So as this sets sail this way, I'm gonna head on to Put-in Bay, and you know where I have to stop first? The boardwalk.
The boardwalk, you gotta get the bisque, or my favorite are the tuna nachos.
Tuna nachos.
Tuna nachos. You heard it from Nicole.
I heard it from you heard it from her. Make sure you get them when you go there. That's where we're headed. Well, I must say I've gotten a pretty warm welcoming, or should I say cool welcoming from Julie here when I made my way to Put-in Bay. We are at one of the most happening places on the island, the boardwalk.
Yes.
This is a must stop.
Absolutely, it is, 100%. You gotta stop here, for sure.
So before we get into everything the boardwalk, what did you bring for me? These look awesome!
I brought you two of our most popular drinks out here. This is the jalapeno margarita with fresh squeezed lemon and lime juice, muddled jalapeno and cilantro.
Forget that, let's try
yeah, a little sugar.
That sounds amazing. You had me in jalapeno.
Little sweet, little spicy, it's a good one.
Wow, that is delicious. When you think summertime, you think the boardwalk and a drink like this.
Yes, I know.
And then what else did you make for me?
So this is our Corona-rita. It's a frozen margarita with a little coronita, a little Corona on top there. And people love this. It's a lot of fun.
I've been here, can you believe this, one time to Put-in-Bay before
what?
This? I know.
Come on.
This is the place I remember the most.
Oh,
it's what sticks with me because it is just so much fun. So we'll get on the first floor here. It's more of a fast casual environment.
Yes. We have a couple different options for people, which I think is really nice. We have our boardwalk main deck, which is fast casual, different concessions that people can order from. The order's made for them right away, and they can just sit on any of our decks and enjoy. And then we have the upper deck right behind me here, where we have full tableside service with servers, a little bit more upscale menu. We have steaks, salads, pasta. So we have a little bit of everything.
And I remember when I came, the one thing that was to die for that everyone raves about, that you have a sign up there for, or you have a flag hanging for.
Yes, with the bisque.
The bisque, right? I feel like you're known for the bisque
here. We are. It's homemade. We actually have two girls that it is their job to make it fresh all day long, every day. So it's all real Maine lobster. It's delicious.
So this is a place where you can come for a great afternoon lunch, mm-hmm. or to come here and do the dining dinner.
Absolutely, yes. You could do a casual lunch and then sit down for a little bit nicer dinner, absolutely.
Now when it comes to the casual lunch downstairs, mm-hmm. what all do you have?
We have three different food concessions. We have our burger, the little galley where you can get cheeseburgers, hot dogs, chicken tenders, a great spot for the kids. We have our fish shack, which we do Lake Erie perch and walleye, hand breaded to order. And we have the book seafood line where you can get lobster, crab, shrimp, our bisque, and some grilled really good sandwiches.
So you can get the bisque downstairs too?
Yes, you can get on both floors.
Okay, that's good to know.
Yes.
And then, again, you come up here for the dining, mm-hmm. and it is exquisite dining, mm-hmm. and really you have just about anything of American cuisine mixed with some other things.
You know, just traditional American cuisine. We have steaks, pasta dishes, nice salads that are entree size. We do wraps, burgers, a little bit of everything.
I like that. And then, okay, so this is where she just got the string from me. And we're up at, what is this called up here, the cantina?
This is Rita's Cantina Deck.
Rita's Cantina
Our margarita tequila bar. We feature some fresh squeezed craft margaritas up here. So yeah, they're delicious.
I love to come up here. I would think this would be a great spot when you're out on your boat, mm-hmm. and you just want to stroll right over, get a nice drink, then go back even if you want to sit on the boat again.
Absolutely.
It's the perfect location for that.
It really is.
And then you have another bar that's up in the front?
We do. We have a rum bar. It's called Clawdaddy's, where we feature Pusser's Painkillers and Pina Coladas and Mojitos.
What is the first one?
Pusser's Painkillers.
That sounds interesting and intriguing.
Delicious. It's
is that a drink?
It's a rum-based drink with Coco Lopez, which is like a fresh coconut. It's like a little sweet, and it's really good. It's very good.
So, talking about the attire, mm-hmm. I mean, if we come up here during the day, I remember when I came up, I had a bathing suit on and came and hung out up here. You can do that, just have a cover-up, right?
Exactly, yeah. The upper deck, you are required, it's a little bit nicer dress, but the decks, the boardwalk main deck, you can just come as you are, yeah.
I love this. And what I like about this is it's very family-friendly. The kids, I've saw so many kids downstairs walking around.
Yes, family-friendly for sure. That's definitely, you know, our environment here. We want to make it comfortable for all ages and all styles of families. And yeah, absolutely.
I love it. This place, the boardwalk has been here for a very long time,
right? Yes, we have. Since 1984. So
1984 is a long time. I know that year all too well. So it's been here for a while.
Yes.
But again, it's a staple. It's somewhere you have to come and visit. I know you will. I mean, you can't pass this place up when you're here in Put-in-Bay. Thanks so much.
Yeah, thank you.
For this wonderful drink,
too.
Enjoy
it. Again. Enjoy it.
I'll take this any day of the week. We'll be
you.
Back with much more from Put-in-Bay after this. We're just getting started.
Across the water there, that is Rattlesnake Island.
Welcome back to our road trip here at Put-in-Bay. You know, once you get to the island, one of the things you might want to do is hop on board a little tram that will take you around called Island Transportation, and this guy, Chip, will be your guide. You have other guys to help out too, right?
Yep.
So what, when they get onto the tram, where else does it take them? All over the island?
It's called the Tour Train. Island Transportation is the name of our company. We cover the entire island. We give you all of the history of the island along the way.
This is Jose de Rivera's original homestead. They started the winemaking process in both of these older barns.
We give you the option to make various stops outside of the downtown area. We come by every so often to pick you back up, stretch it out the last several hours, and we really push the history of the island. It's completely narrated and it's fun for the entire family.
Well, so that's great. So once you come to a stop, you can get off,
yes,
walk around absolutely a little, and then you pick them back up again. Now, we're at one of the locations,
correct,
that you stopped. Now, what is this? I've never been over here before.
Perry's Cave. This is the Perry's Cave Family Fun Center, where we've got an antique car museum, got a cave we give tours of a number of caves on the island. We have miniature golf, a beautiful butterfly house, a maze for the kids to get lost in.
So it's really fun to bring the kids on this kind of tour,
We try. Oh, absolutely. Family-oriented.
Now, there are some really historic stops that you make, too.
Sure. Perry's Monument is one of them, the third tallest national monument in the country. We stop at the Dollar Mansion. We stop at the Aquatic Center on the days that it's opened. Heinemann's Winery was founded in 1888. That's one of our historic stops. That's right across the street.
Off to your right, across the water there, that is Rattlesnake Island. Not named that because there's a lot of rattlesnakes on the island. It is named that for its shape.
It's a really neat island itself to see. And if you haven't been here before, or even if you have and you decided maybe not to do something like this, I think it's really great to look at all of the aspects of this. Not just about the downtown area and a bunch of partying.
A lot more than that. We've got a lot for families to do here.
Well, it's about a lot of history. It has a lot of history, this
sure
island.
Sure do.
And if anyone would know that, it would probably be you, because this man was born and raised on this island. So you know, dating back quite some time, even probably your ancestors too.
Yeah, we moved here from another island in 1908. We were on that other island in Lake Erie before we came here, though.
What do you think would be something about this island that makes it so special that a lot of people, when they come here, overlook or don't really know?
The history we have with winemaking here on the island.
At the highest point of it, 90% of this island was covered in vineyards, and we had 20 wineries.
So how often can we take these tours?
Every half hour.
Wow. Every day
All
of the
day
week?
Long. Every day of the week, June, July, and August. See the island on the train, then go back and check out what you like best.
There we go. All right. Now, coming up right now, we're going to take you to a place that you can spend the night here on Put-in Bay, and it is in the heart of things downtown. Well, if you love the entertainment, you love the nightlife, and you also want to stay right here in downtown, Ashley has just the place for you.
Yes, Edgewater Hotel.
So it's right behind us here, and you really are in the thick of things.
Right in the heart of downtown, yes.
So clearly this is going to be a happening place. There's going to be a lot going on right around here. But I can tell already by looking at the spot that there are a lot of great features that you have here. One of them being some really brand new updated rooms.
Yes, brand new this winter from floor to ceiling. We have 10 rooms. Six or eight of the rooms have, you can sleep up to six people, and two of the rooms you can sleep up to four.
Okay, now walking in those rooms, they're pretty awesome. I know they're newly renovated,
they
but
are.
I mean, you have that awesome pull-out couch. You have in the ones that sleep up to six, mm-hmm. the two beds, the refrigerator. I'm looking for like a little mini fridge. It's not
full
a mini fridge.
Full-size refrigerator, microwave, everything.
So when it comes to the amount of space that you have there, how many rooms do you have to rent?
10.
So 10. So I'm guessing that it's even more of an incentive to book early when you get to a
yes,
place like this.
Absolutely. Absolutely. We are booked far into the summer.
I hear you have some awesome suite specials too.
We do. We have the manager specials for those families who like to come during the week. We include a golf cart with it. So even though we are in the heart of downtown, if they wanted to go sightseeing on the other side of the island, that golf cart is included in the rooms.
And I noticed right underneath, so if you want to stay here and you don't want to put something in the refrigerator, right underneath, you can also get some great sandwiches.
Yep. Pizza and sandwiches.
Oh, and pizza too. Wow. Now, another great thing, another great factor I think you have right here connected to the hotel is the ATM. So if you ever need to get cash out real
yes.
quick, you got a spot that's right next to you here as well.
Yes.
Now, throughout the day, do people come in here, I'm guessing, once they come out of the rooms, come and hang out at the park?
They do, yep. They come, hang out at the park, go to the different restaurants, bars.
All right, Ash, I want to talk about convenience here. Because when you come into this resort in the hotel, you literally just have to get from the Jet Express 2 feet away from you, basically.
Right. The Jet Express is just a block away. Very convenient. It's right in the heart of downtown where everything's at. So if you go one place during the day and then you want to go back to the room and freshen up, you're just a couple steps away.
I know there's a ton of golf carts driving around, but you don't even need one of those if you're staying
no,
here.
No. If you're staying downtown, everything's right here. You don't even need a golf cart.
Now, when we're talking the type of people that might rent this, is it considered family friendly or just more of an adult-based place?
Both, actually. On the weekends, it's more adults, but during the week, families love staying here. They're right here where everything is. There's access to pools for families, and then also there's swim-up bars for those
for those who want to go and maybe stay cool and also have a drink while they're there too. Well, that's a good point to make, I think, too, because the hotel itself does not have a pool connected to it, but you have access to nearby pools.
Yes.
And you have access to the lake right there, too, if you feel like jumping in that as well, right?
Maybe the fountain.
Although I bet you might get in a little bit of trouble if you jump in there. The police might have something to say about that.
Yeah.
I love this spot. Again, if you want to really feel like you're in the heart and in the thick of things 24 hours a day, this is the place to come.
Great spot.
Hey, and speaking of entertainment and some good food that's just down the road, right after the break, we're taking you to one of the best spots. Welcome back to our road trip here at Put-in Bay, and I think one of the things you're going to have to come and try out, if you haven't already, is the boathouse here. Kevin, I must say, coming by, walking along, looking at everybody's food as I was before, I thought, I have to go in there and stop and eat something. It looks so good.
There's no question we have great food.
It's delicious, and I know you put out a little display for us today. Are these some of the ones that when people come, they gotta get?
These are definitely some of our great signature dishes.
What did you put in front of me? Because this looks delicious.
This is my personal favorite. This is our Cajun jambalaya. Our menu is basically bar food with a New Orleans twist, and this is one of our featured New Orleans dishes. It's got a little kick to it.
It has a little kick, not too much.
No, not too much. It's just it's mild but spicy, and it's got some good Cajun smoked sausage in there and some Creole sauce
portion,
on the top. It's a very hearty portion.
Big! We could have two people eating that. Yeah. Now that, tell me that doesn't look interesting and yet absolutely delicious.
This is sort of our answer. We're not open for breakfast. We open at 11 for lunch, and this is our colossal brunch burger. And it's actually nicknamed the waffle burger. So what it is we've got the burger, you know, this is our 8-ounce burger patty that we use on our regular burgers. Mm-hmm. And then there's a hash brown patty, cheddar cheese, fried egg, bacon, and then the bun is a waffle. So that's why we serve it with a side of maple syrup, and you're all set.
Am I allowed to say that it's probably really good hangover food?
Didn't know if I, that's what I was going to say.
I'm saying it. I'm going there. You need something to fill up and coat your tummy, right?
That's the neighborhood we're in, so that's...
All right, so now this is going a little bit spicier, huh?
Yeah, this is actually a very spicy dish. So this is our stuffed peppers. This is marinara sauce on the bottom, and these are banana peppers stuffed with Italian sausage and mozzarella cheese. The peppers themselves are what makes this dish so hot. And the combination of flavors with the sausage and these banana peppers is to die for. This is really, truly one of my favorite dishes.
That would always be something that I order when I come to a place. Yeah. I love stuffed peppers.
Nice and hot.
So you brought some drinks with you too. So this is a place where you gotta come and get the food, but you have an awesome bar. You look like you're really in a boat when you go inside.
Yeah.
And they have great drinks.
It is. This is the best place to be. It's the boathouse, and it's all boat themed. And we have lots of fish on the menu also. And some of our featured drinks, this is probably our drink that we've been known for the longest, the best. This is called the Pool Party.
Mm. And I can only imagine that there's a lot in there.
Yeah, there's raspberry vodka and a bunch of other stuff. So you have to ask one of my bartending experts to get all the ingredients. But
It should be a secret recipe. It's that good.
It is.
Mojito, yeah. I'm guessing.
That's a mojito. That's just a good traditional mojito where we muddle the mint and the lime and the sugar and rum and soda, and it's an absolutely delicious, very refreshing. This is a drink for a hot day.
There you go. Now, I know this place has been around for quite some time, right here on Put-in Bay?
Yeah.
How many years?
The boathouse has been here since the mid-70s.
Wow. So it's seen its fair share of parties here on Put-in
Bay. Oh, yeah. Yeah, if these pirates could talk, we have...
we probably don't even want to know.
We have these statue pirates throughout and when I first came here, I thought, these pirates seem a little tacky. I don't know if we want to have these pirates. And the second we open the doors, there's people come right. The people are having their pictures
taken
with them.
Take their picture with it. I'm sure they also love the entertainment, too.
Absolutely. We've been voted from several sources as Put-in Bay's best music venue. We have a great stage up here where all the rock bands play on Friday and Saturday nights. We have the small stage over here where we have single and duo acts during the week. Our music is mostly good old rock and roll, a lot of 80s hair bands, things like that. And then sometimes during the week we feature some funk bands and some original stuff too to mix it up a little bit.
And I know it's been around forever, but you do have sort of a new addition that where if you walk along the back side, it connects over to another area now?
Yeah, we have sort of we have our outside patio here on this side, and then if you go through there, we have now a German beer garden is our back patio.
Something different.
So there's an inside bar in there and a back patio where we serve this whole array of bratwurst and Bavarian pretzels and German-style food and German beer on tap. So it's a neat little new twist that we have.
I'm set to go.
You can't leave until you clean your plate.
You're going to have to help me.
No dessert in this.
There's no way. No one, you know what? In all my years, no one has ever said that to me before. And I don't think this is the plate I could do it on, to be honest with you.
We'll be glad to give you a to-go box.
All right. I'll take a to-go box. And I might be able to find a place to put it in a refrigerator at our next stop, which you can also rent to sleep at night. That's where we're going. Well, I just so happened to find another place where you can not only rest your head here when you stay on the island, but also swim and get a great drink here at the bar. And I have Amber with me to take us through this awesome place. We are at Put-in Bay Resort and Conference Center. Yes. So you really do it all here.
We do, absolutely.
So when people come and they want to book a place like this, what do you think makes this kind of stand out, or who would be a great fit for wanting to stay here on the island?
We're very family friendly during the week, and then we gear toward the adult crowd on the weekends. This is a unique property because I can accommodate a group as small as 2 individuals up to a party of 12 in one room.
Wow. All right, so you can really bring a whole entire family with you and you'd be good to go in one room.
Yeah, absolutely.
I like the sound of this. Now, the pool in itself is pretty awesome. You're right here along the side of one of the buildings. Now, the space I see behind us, this is also all you over here?
It is. We do have multiple buildings. We've added on every year until we've grown to as large as we are.
The first one bar on the island, yes. And it's one of the first to ever open here.
Yeah, when people every came year to we're Bay. The first one to be open for the season.
Oh, so you know where to come when you want to get to the island early.
That's right.
So Nick, he whips up some awesome drinks over there, I can see.
He does.
This is our signature cocktail. It's our fishbowl. Smirnoff raspberry, little blue Hawaiian pucker, some Sprite and lemonade, and garnish with some Swedish fish. And that's the fishbowl.
Now, one of the newest additions, I know you said you keep adding on, is that behind us right here?
Yes, that's our courtyard building. That was constructed last year.
Now, what all makes that special compared to maybe what we have over here?
In that building, I have rooms that sleep 4 and 6 individuals. Like I said, it's a brand new structure, so it's state of the art. Everything in the room is brand new.
Now, when people come here to stay, I can only imagine that sometimes with all the other great things that they have to do on the island, they don't necessarily need to leave if they don't want to for a few hours, because really it becomes an area where you can do just about anything.
Absolutely. We encourage everyone to stay here all day. You know, it's a quiet location, so when you're done for the day, done for the evening, you're not going to hear the hustle and bustle of downtown. But we have everything here, so you don't need to leave downtown.
So can we touch on the conference center aspect of this?
Absolutely. We are the only property on the island to have on-site conference facilities. So our conference rooms are located within the guest rooms of the property. So if you're having a meeting and someone needs to step away to make a private phone call or maybe check their email, they're located right on site so they don't have to leave.
Okay, now talking a little bit more about the rooms, what kind of amenities do we have?
It's a basic hotel room, so it has everything that you'll need. All of our rooms have ironing boards with irons, in-room safes, blow dryers, anything that you can need. We have soap dispensers, shampoo dispensers, anything that you forgot from home, we're probably going to have you covered here.
Like the sound of that. And you also have a breakfast buffet?
We do. We offer continental breakfast every day of the week but Saturdays. It's an upgraded breakfast. We even offer some hot stuff on there to fill you up on Sunday before you take off.
The free continental breakfast already sounds appealing, but what else when it comes to food do you offer?
We have food service at the bar, and we also offer late night pizza service. So after you've been out and had your good time with your friends all evening, you can come back at 3 a.m. and order a pizza from us too.
I know this is where we're gonna stay. We absolutely love it already. And I think that if you're thinking about coming here and you're wondering about how to book this, I'm sure that people jump on this, so you kind of have to do this in advance.
Absolutely. Some days we'll book up as far as a year in advance, especially our villas that sleep 12
Whoa,
people.
A year in advance.
Yeah, but most of our guest rooms usually are full within 3 to 6 months in advance.
Well, I know where I'm gonna rest my head tonight, that's for sure. Thank you, Amber, for showing us around.
Thank
and you know what I think it's time to do? Even though I see a pool here, I think we gotta go hit the water. Well, Welcome back to our road trip here in Put-in Bay. Remember what I said before the break, it's time to hit the water? Well, Bob's going to show us several ways we can do it here at Put-in Bay Watercraft Rentals.
Absolutely,
Natalie. You have it all.
Yes, we do. There's a lot of things to do down here. We have powered watercraft like jet skis, and we have power boats that they can get out and be a captain on the Great Lake, you know. It might be on their bucket list. We have some great scenery out here, of course. We can, and it's a lot closer than Bahamas.
I mean, it is a lot closer than Bahamas. And this shot is so picturesque, and on a beautiful day like this, that's the place you gotta be. I mean, I know you can go at night on the island and go everywhere, but the water is the place to be during the day.
We're on an island, and so, you know, you can see certain things from the land, but getting on a boat, you can see things you just can't see from the land.
So how does it work then? Let's start with boats. How does it work then if they want to rent a boat?
Well, they can make reservations at our website, which is pibjetski.com, P-I-B like Put-in Bay, jetski.com, and they can just plunk their Visa card down or PayPal, pick out the date, the watercraft that they want, and it's all done. When you come down here, we ask them to show up a little bit early because anybody who's born on or after January 1st, 1982, the Coast Guard says that we need to get you to pass a little bit of a test. It's 10 questions, not a big deal. Usually takes about 20 minutes or so. So we have you show up a little bit earlier for that. But if you're old like me, you don't have to take the test. But you still have to do the safety orientation, which is a few minutes. We show everybody how to operate whichever watercraft they're getting out on the water because we've never had an accident. We certainly don't want to start anytime soon.
Right.
So we show them exactly how and when they feel confident, we get them out there on the water.
So the boats, when it comes to that, how many people can you get on one of those things?
We have boats from two people all the way up to five people. The five-person boat, they're all kind of small craft and great for a calm day like this. Mm-hmm. And so on the five-person, it's really probably for three or four adults and maybe a child or so, so we can accommodate families that way. The sightseeing tour can take any size of person as long as we're up to six people, and we have several different captains that take them out on the water.
Oh, so you can sit back and relax on the sightseeing tour.
Absolutely.
Someone else does the driving in the boat.
Yes, ma'am. If you don't want to do all that testing and you want to learn how to operate the boat, or maybe you're a little nervous, something like that, we have captains, licensed from the Coast Guard, who could take you out on a sightseeing tour. There's so much history around here. It's incredible, all the stories here. And we have all kinds of different captains. We got one that's a sailing guy from the Caribbean. We've got one who's a retired iron ore freighter who's got stories from all the way from Sault Ste. Marie all the way down to the Welland Canal. It's really awesome. We have me, the local rock star, who's also
of
a captain.
Of course, the rock star. We've got to have you in the mix.
Right? You can go out there. If you don't want to do any work, we can just have you sit back in luxury and have them tell us stories, because this island is so historic. And, you know, to make it real quick, we won our independence, and then the British were picking on us, so we started a war at the 1812, and we beat the British right outside our port here, and it was such an important and decisive victory that they built the third tallest national monument here on the island. And that's the Perry's Victory and International Peace Memorial. And that's a great thing to visit while you're up here.
So is it pretty close to where we are, too, then?
It's sort of midway on the island. The island's about a couple, 3 miles long, and that's sort of right in the middle.
So you could do it on your way to and from, because if you want to, you can rent, now correct me here, help me out in saying this, you can rent a golf cart near where the pretty close to where the jet to ferry is?
Yes, ma'am. You can. We also have a cart rental that makes it real convenient, because when you want to drive here, the best way to get around the island is a golf cart, truly, because there's a lot of golf carts, kind of like Mackinac Island. Some we also have cars, but driving a car is bigger than the golf carts, and it's just not as fun. You've got all this open air with the golf cart, you know.
True.
So you can either get off at the automobile ferry, the Miller Ferry over here, and there's a bus right at the top of the hill that will drop you off right in front of AB Cart Rentals, which is our sister company. Or you can take the jet, and we're just a block from there. You can also make reservations for the golf cart at AB Cart Rental, and we have a discount. So if you want to rent a boat and you want to rent a golf cart, we're going to make you a special deal.
I love this. You can stop by these really touristy places when you're coming here to go out on the water. Now, we talked about the boats. We talked about how to get out and just do a little sightseeing. But when you want to kind of get out on your own, maybe by yourself and power it up, Jet skis
are awesome. Now, it's a little bit more work, and they're faster machines, so there's a little bit longer, just a few minutes safety orientation, because, again, we want to keep everybody safe, but it's a lot of fun. Those things get really fast, and so once we get you out on the water, we keep you in an area about 3 or 4 square miles where our staff can watch you the whole time, so if there's any problems, we can take care of it. We have those. We also have the power boats, and that's all of our powered watercraft.
But you also have things like kayaks, which if you want a little bit more of a relax, I'm not as much of a jet ski kind of girl. I'd rather get in a paddle boat
and kayak,
something like that, and just relax a bit.
Yes, the jet skis are great, but there's a little bit of spray involved, and I know that when my wife's hair gets wet, my day is going downhill. So
that's not it for me. I'm just afraid of going too fast.
Right. So, and the kayaks are a lot of fun because, you know, it's a little bit more work paddling and stuff, but The cool thing about the kayak is you can get really close up to shore, whereas the powered boats and the sightseeing tours and the jet skis and so forth, we keep away from shore for safety. The kayaks can come right up close, so you can get closer to nature and you're right down there on water, you dip your hand in the water. It's a lot of fun, and I see a lot of wives going in the front and then the husbands are in back doing the paddling, you know?
And they just sit back and relax.
Are you allowed
to bring a water or anything
yes,
out
ma'am.
In the water with
yeah,
you?
Yeah, absolutely.
How sweet he is too. He's calling me ma'am. Quit calling me.
Well, it's an old habit from my dad was from Texas. I can't help it.
Oh, see, we got a good down home Texas guy here taking care of us
yep.
at the Watercraft Rental Place. And I know you have the paddle boards too, so really
yes.
just about anything you want to do out on the water, you guys can
absolutely.
Make it
we have them for single and for doubles. So if you want to go just yourself, that's fine. We can either put you in a stand-up paddle board or we can put you in a kayak. If you have two, we can put you in a tandem as well.
I like the sound of it. Hey, have you ever heard of the place The Keys?
Yes.
All right, well, after you're done out on the water, you can go and head to that. So that's what we're going to do.
That's a fantastic place. It's one of the Booker properties. Great restaurant.
That's where we're headed. La 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 la. Well, when you're done with the tour, I found the perfect place to come and unwind. What screams islands more than drinks? Eric in his awesome green shirt, our
hey.
Pineapple friend here. We're at the Keys. Are you sure we're in Northeast Ohio?
We are,
I feel
we
like
are,
we're down
right
in Florida.
Here. We're your neighbors from Cleveland.
I love it.
Lake Erie, the Florida Keys. We bring this to you in Ohio and Lake Erie. How about
this
that?
This is the most tropical place on the island for sure.
Oh, thank you very much. We love it, we love it. Inspired by the Florida Keys. Great spot to come visit. Great food, great drinks. We love it here.
Speaking of drinks, this is the famous Bushwhacker.
Yeah, the Bushwhacker. You're gonna love the Bushwhacker.
Why am I gonna love it? I'm worried. I think after one of these, I'd be in trouble.
Maybe two.
Maybe two.
Yeah, it might take two.
I think he's giving me some credit there that it'll take two of these things. Okay. What's in this? Do you know?
Chocolate.
It's not like I put you behind the bar making these.
Yeah. I don't really know what's in it.
Doesn't matter. I think it would only take one. I think it
was. Oh my gosh, but this zombie? This zombie is amazing.
Doesn't matter what's in them, you gotta just come try them. The bartender's whipping up some awesome drinks back there. So we're sitting in, I feel like, the best spot here in the Keys, because you can see all the different aspects of this place.
We are. You're surrounded by water. We've got a marina right out front. We're located right next to the Jet Express dock, so you can come on over here on the Jet Express.
The boats, when they come in too, the dock's right there for them as well, if you're bringing in your own boat.
Yes.
So this is such a great, the view that you have from this spot. Now, you have several different areas, as I mentioned. So over here, what bar do we have there?
Lola's Key right there.
And then behind you, so bright and yellow, I love that.
Tortugas, yes. And it's a lot of fun. And again, we have the Pilar in there, which is, we have the transom of the Pilar, which is Hemingway's boat. Yeah.
Oh, in there.
Yeah, how about that?
See, there's so many things you can't miss when you come. And behind us, I love this little shack that you have.
The Tiki Shack, and we do feature Fat Tuesday's drinks. And they are
every day
delicious.
Of the week or just Tuesdays?
No, every day of the week.
I love it.
Every day of the week.
Every day of the week it's a party. Every day is not Tuesday.
Yes.
And there's so many great little lounge chairs and areas for you to just come and sit, get one of the drinks, but get the food too. So I hate to say this to you. I think we're going to have to put our friend down,
even though
it screams island life, because we're going to fill this table up with
we
some food.
We are going to try some delicious food.
Here it
Absolutely.
Goes. This is going bye-bye.
All right.
Here comes
see ya.
The food.
Uh-oh.
So you brought the flatbreads out, and I see Raven's coming up here with the rest of the food. We're gonna take up the whole table right now, folks.
All right, Raven, here we go.
Look at this.
Some conch fritters.
Conch
here
fritters.
Here we go.
Jerk
we're just gonna load them on.
The jerk chicken. Oh my
jerk
gosh.
Summertime salad.
The grouper Reuben,
one of my favorites right
Thank you,
there.
Raven. All right, Thank so you. Wait, I gotta start with this then. The grouper Reuben?
Yes, the grouper. How about
that's
that?
A different take on a Reuben.
Inspired by the Keys, of course.
Love it. Yeah. And that looks delicious.
Isn't that nice? Oh my gosh, we are going to eat. And of course, the conch fritters. Come on.
Okay, so that's inspired too by the Keys.
Yes, it is.
Right?
Yes. We don't really get the conch from Lake Erie, but we have them up here in Lake Erie. So, conch
fritters,
everybody.
So you got to get
them with
you. And the jerk chicken, that could feed about 3 people, it looks like.
It's going to feed me right now. Absolutely.
You got to wait until we're done talking about the rest of it, at least.
All right.
The salad, though, if you want to go a little bit lighter in the afternoon.
Yeah, how about that? Summertime salad, it's beautiful.
I like the looks of that.
And the Keys flatbread, and then the margarita flatbread.
I like
right
the looks of that margarita flatbread too. So this is such an awesome afternoon atmosphere, but I know at night it transforms and still so inviting. I know you have that fire pit going all the time.
Yes, yeah, the vibe down here at night with the tiki torches and the fire pit, live entertainment too. It's just a great vibe. It puts you on vacation as soon as you set onto the property.
So I like that it kind of, it's a little different than everything you're going to see right along the main downtown area. It's a little more of an island vibe even in the nighttime.
It is an island
more
vibe.
More relaxed.
No lines, no shoulder to shoulder, you're spaced out. You get to talk to people, you get to listen to some great bands.
You do have awesome live music here
we
too.
We do, yeah, we do. Yeah, you can check that out on the website.
All right, you got to check it on the website. And then I know once a year you do an awesome event.
The full moon party.
Full moon party.
July and August. You don't want to miss it. All you can eat Hawaiian inspired goodness, barbecue. We do a pig. We have flamethrowers and belly dancers. It's great. It's a lot of fun.
I love this guy. And now I understand why people want to come here all the time, because if I feel like you embody what this is all about. The food's delicious. It's an awesome atmosphere. And
let's enjoy it, right?
Like scoop them up, put them in my bag, and take them with me back home to Cleveland. This is awesome. Thanks so much for having
Thank
us
you
here.
So much. I appreciate it.
I'm loving Clinton Bay. We'll be right back after this short break.
Get back to the zombie.
Back with Ashley here. Now, we were talking about Edgewater Hotel a little bit earlier on in the show. So right next to it is Delaware Cart Rentals. And when it comes to renting carts, of course you can do it all over the island, but you are very flexible here, and I like the sound of that.
We are very flexible. We are the latest on the island. We do overnight golf carts because we are gas powered, so they don't have to be charged at night. It's really great for those who ride the Jet Express when they have the late night ferry. With us being the latest return, it works out for those passengers.
Now, when it comes to renting the carts, how many can you accommodate? What do you go up to?
We have 4-seaters, 6-seaters, and 8-seaters. You can rent them hourly, daily, or like I said, overnight. For a 4-seater, an hour is $12. For the day, it's $60, and overnight, it's $80. And that's until noon the following day. 6-seaters, they're $18 an hour, $70 for the day, or $90 until noon the following day. And 8-seaters are $22 an hour, $90 for the day, or $110 until noon the following day.
I feel like if you have a group of people together chipping in a little bit of money here and there, here goes a few people right now.
Yeah.
That's an 8-seater?
That's a 6-seater.
That's a 6-seater.
6-seater.
So that's really accommodating too, I think, when it comes to the prices. I would do a day instead of an hour, even if
Absolutely.
It's worth the price.
Yep, and split it up between the number of people that are with you. It's a good deal.
Because after a while, walking back and forth around the island might get a little tiring on your legs, so it's good to have some kind of way to get around.
Right.
Now, it's not just about carts, and that's what else I like about this. Now, you also have bicycles.
We have bicycles, yes. They're $5 an hour, $20 for the day. A lot of families like to come and get the bicycles and go over to the state park.
Well, that would be a fun thing to do when you think about it, too. So, and get you some exercise too.
Yeah.
Because all of the great
sure
eating and the food that you
yes.
have here, you can get on the bike.
Yeah.
And as we talk about it, I see more people driving by a bike. So that's a good aspect. And then you have the mopeds.
We do. We have the mopeds. They're 1-seater mopeds. They're $15 an hour or $60 for the day. Everyone just has a ball on them. Everyone loves them.
So do they still use those just to get around from place to place? Or is it more of just let's joyride around the island on a moped?
They do both. They go place to place. But I had some customers yesterday who they had them from 8 in the morning until 8 at night, and they just drove all around the island, all day, all night long.
So when you just make sure you secure them in a certain way, right? Because we don't want anybody taking the wrong
Correct.
Moped, right?
Yes, we do have specific keys for the moped, so as long as they take the key out, they're good.
So it's really nice because, you know, when you come up here, bringing a car is something you really don't want to do. There's not a lot of parking.
Right, and there's not very much room with all the golf carts going by, bicycles, people walking. Golf carts, mopeds, bicycles are the way to go.
And it seems like everyone, no matter what type of vehicle you're using to get around, everyone gets around each other okay, pretty smoothly around.
Yeah, yeah.
I like the sound of this. So again, if you want to make sure that you're getting out and about and you're not walking all day long, come to Delaware Rentals. Ashley will be here to help you out.
We'll help you.
And get some good food right underneath too. All right, when we come back, more from Put in Bay. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back to our road trip here at Put-in Bay. We have time for one more stop, and I thought, why not come to Bay Lodge and Resort? Landon's gonna give us a little tour here because this is probably the farthest away from downtown, so this is gonna be the quietest location if you wanna stay somewhere.
Right, yeah, that's what's unique about this property is that it's sequestered from like the rest of the town, so if there's a family or someone that's coming, I normally recommend that they come here. It's just because it's not as busy and there's not as much action, so they can relax, you know, at our bar and pool.
And it's more of a boutique hotel in a sense that you only have how many rooms here?
Gosh, I think it's 49 rooms here. So 49. Not as large as the other properties.
A little more intimate.
Right, yeah.
But you know what I do love after standing right out here in the pool area? Is not only do you have an indoor pool, or outdoor pool, I should say,
right.
It goes right in.
Exactly, yeah. Our pool is unique because it extends outdoors, but it's also wraps around there, as you can see, and that's an indoor pool. So it gives our guests like a unique experience because, you know, if it's raining or something mm-hmm. outside, or, you know, they could just go inside.
Just swim right through the little door. I love the doorway here. And I love the fact that this is a Buckeye bar. A lot of people from around this area huge Buckeye
exactly,
fans.
Exactly, yeah.
So you have the awesome chair for people to sit in and take some pictures.
Right.
And the bar behind us.
Absolutely, yeah. Go Bucks.
There you go. Now, this is a place where you come if you want to just get drinks. Now, I know you don't have food technically at the bar.
Right.
However, there's something unique about the rooms.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is the only property that we have that has king-size rooms. So if you're looking just, you know, for you and your wife to come, it's like a perfect place to come here, get away and relax. We have king size rooms, and then this property is unique because we also have rooms that have kitchens in them. Mm-hmm. So it's like a kitchenette area. You know, I guess if you don't want to go out, you can cook your own food in your room.
You can cook in the room. It might save you a little bit of money too one night if you want to do something like that. So that's a great feature to this as well.
Mm-hmm.
I tell you, this place is so neat. And I'm watching the planes come in and out of
here.
Oh
yeah, they go by all the time.
So you get to see a little bit of excitement too, even if you're not downtown.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah, it's not too far away. I mean, the island's only, 3 miles by 5 miles, so nothing's going to be too far away from everyone else, but it's just right, you know, where you're kind of out of the way from all the hustle and bustle of, like, the main strip.
What's the easiest way for people to get to and from here?
Actually, we rent golf carts on the spot just for that reason. We have 4, 6, and 8 passenger golf carts that we rent.
Oh, 8 too.
Oh, I know,
all
yes.
All the way up.
So if you're bringing your larger group here, maybe staying in one of our suites, then we can rent you a golf cart, and then you can just drive it like a normal car, you know, on the roads, around the island, get you where you need to go.
So you do accommodate then, it starts with, I'm guessing, 2 people, but you can go all the way up to how many?
Oh, absolutely, yeah. You can have like a standard room, like a king bed that would accommodate 2 people, and we have like large suites that are actually multi-level, and those accommodate up to 10 people.
Wow. So even though it's a smaller hotel,
mm-hmm.
you can still fit a lot of people into one space here.
Yeah, this area normally gets pretty crowded on the weekends, you know, because we max out, you know, have full capacity on the weekends, a lot of people.
And I know that you mentioned that you have your own kitchenette areas in some of those suites.
Right.
In the other rooms though, you even have microwaves? And
yeah, in our suites, they all come with microwaves. All of the rooms have mini fridges, and I guess if the ladies are concerned, they have hair dryers. I know I got asked that this morning.
The ladies will be concerned, although with this humidity that you have here, sometimes I'm sure they just forgo the hair dryers.
Yeah.
But it's good to know that you have them just in
Absolutely.
Case.
Absolutely.
I can tell that you might need one too sometimes,
gosh.
Right?
Is it? Surprising?
No, it looks good.
I know, I'm kidding.
All right, so hey, we're wrapping up the show. So you know what that means?
What does
that
mean?
I think it is time for us to maybe get a drink.
Oh.
I've done my work today.
That sounds great.
Right? All right, let's go back and hit the bar.
Okay.
We'll see you in a minute. Well, I think that's my time here on the island. I don't want to leave. I have forgotten how amazing this place is. It's been 10 years since I've been here, but I promise it's not gonna be 10 years before I come back again. This island has so much to see and do and offer, and I love that you can come up here by boat, or you can take the Jet Express over here. You're here in 30 minutes when you're coming from the mainland. It can be a day trip, it can be a weekend trip, or some people make it a week trip, or they stay the whole summer. So whatever you do, come and enjoy it and explore the rest that we haven't shown you, because of course, we're just getting started. This is Put-in-Bay, folks, and I'm Natalie Herbick, and we'll see you on the next New Day Cleveland.